Chris and McKaley, this film, so charming, delightful. I loved it from beginning to end. It's one of those you just kind of sit and watch with a smile on your face. David said the line, and I had to Facebook it out, where he says, maybe you just need to smile. A cheerful heart is good medicine.
Yeah, right? That's like, a really good line. Yeah.
That's like some nice words of wisdom right there. But isn't that, that's to me, that's what this movie is. It's feel good. You get something from it.
Right.
You just said it all, brother. Thanks, Jared. Yeah.
Thanks.
Yeah.
I'll just...
That's it. Interview's done.
Yeah, thank you. Bye.
Boom, done. No, but when you guys do get a script like this, is there a specific aspect that you're like, that's what I'm interested in exploring? Is it the total package? What really made you say, okay, I've got to do this?
I really think it was the total package for me, because I just felt like there were so many storylines and so many messages throughout the film that like everyone that watches this can find something to relate to.
Yeah, yeah.
And that's what I loved so much about it. I mean, it has one super important message, and then I just loved it.
Yeah. You know, originally the film was titled Produce. It was named after the title, you know, Produce, the character.
Yeah.
And I think though, as Lionsgate and Roadside got behind it, they were like, yeah, but what is that about? What's the movie about?
Mm-hmm.
And every character.
It's not about farmers.
It's not about,
it's not
about a producer in Hollywood, like action. It's and they were like, it's about hope, and it's about, you know, and I think that in our life, we live in a world right now that is, it's we're in some interest. If you turn on the news, it can be pretty depressing.
Yeah,
right.
And I think when you go to Hollywood and you turn to Hollywood as sort of a source of escapism, and it's served that for decades so well, but lately it just feels like every time you go to the theater, you're pummeled with, you know, a few choices.
Mm-hmm.
And when I got the script for this, I was like, this is an awesome story. And Chris Dowling, who wrote it and directed it, his treatment of the subject was so mature and honest and real. It didn't feel saccharine. It doesn't feel pushed. It's just an organic, hopeful story. And you leave the theater and people, man, I've gone and seen it with Albert Pujols Family Foundation. It was half the audience had Down syndrome. And here's a group of people who've never seen themselves on screen for that length of time, represented with a character that has an arc and goes through all these emotional things, and watching themselves on film, on screen, was amazing, because the reactions were visceral and guttural, and it was like all of a sudden it gave them courage and dignity and hope. And, and then I watched it with people who, they were bawling next to me because their kid is at AA and their son's an addict. And, and they're like, now I get what he's going through. And
serious issues, especially when you're seeing it dealt with from the perspective of the child.
Yes.
Which happens, and you don't get a whole lot of that kind of perspective every now and then.
Right.
Yeah. You also had a great line in dealing with the grocery store manager. We don't use the R word like we don't use the N word.
Yeah. It was, you know, and I'm saying it to a person of color. And so it was like, all of a sudden it was like, this is going to hit home. And it's interesting to hear the audience reaction for that line. But you know, what's also interesting is that when you use, you know, that word, the R word, and you're dealing with people who, you know, have special needs, I think if you're not, you forget how entirely insensitive that is, especially for the families, especially for them. So we signed, the whole cast signed we're part of a Stop the R Word movement, and we all signed that.
Yeah, happily.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. So. Yep. The end scene, which I will not give away, it was just so, like, there was just so much, I was so happy seeing that last scene play out, especially because Louisville is my hometown. I grew up right across the river in southern Indiana.
Yeah.
It really is.
Yeah.
Amazing city. It's a fantastic city.
Yeah.
There's so much excitement there. The city, you're at the Bat Stadium, and you don't know what's going to happen in that last scene.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Right.
We don't. It's sad. It's a sad scene.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then completely hopeful and jubilant.
Right. But it ends on a high note.
Right. We just kind of gave
it. I didn't give anything away, because we don't know how that note gets
That's
said.
True.
But
it's all that last 10 minutes of the movie. Some good
so
stuff
sad.
Plays out.
Right,
yeah.
Right. I know. It's so intense towards the end of the movie.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
You got to see it. May 15th.
You really do.
Nationwide.
Check it out. Absolutely.
Yeah.
Congratulations on it, guys. It's
Thank
such
you.
A pleasure meeting and speaking.
Thank you so much.